Hello everyone and welcome back to Let's Play Deus Ex Human Revolution. Today, after spending a lot of time out in the Detroit streets, we aren't done, but we're finally going to move on into the police station. Chapter 4, A Wolf Among Sheep. En route to discover the typhoon, Jensen discovered a purity-first terrorist trying to steal it, but the so-called extremist was secretly augmented and killed himself to avoid interrogation. Hoping to find answers, Jensen confronted Zeke Sanders, the purity-first leader, who swore up and down he didn't know his man was enhanced. Jensen let Sanders escape, determined to focus on the Aug. And there, I've finally read all of those. Good, good, good. Because it takes hours upon hours for one of these videos to upload, I'm actually recording these while my Invisible War videos are still uploading, so I actually don't know if you'll be able to read those or not. Now, I do eventually want to take the front entrance, but one thing that I've been made aware of that's important is that after we convince Wayne Haas to let us in, there are three hacks inside the police station that become unavailable. So the most experientially profitable thing to do is sneak into the station, do those three hacks, and those three hacks only, and then come back around to the front entrance and convince Wayne Haas to let us in and go from there. So we need to go down through the sewer entrance first. Everybody's okay? That's good news. So let's head over to the sewer entrance and go into the police station that way. I'm recording this on the day that the Supreme Court upheld the healthcare law. I'm not going to get into my own views on the matter. Suffice to say, I'm a little bit distracted reading the news. So I apologize if it seems like my mind is a little bit elsewhere. I won't say which direction, but I do care about this, so I'm obsessively reading the news as it comes out and dissecting the opinion. Anyway. Right. Oh. We got spotted by a camera. Gotta be careful. It didn't trigger the alarm, so we're fine. And I need to be more careful. Let's hack this level 2 system to disable these lasers. As you can see, we've got 3 exits. It's gotta pass through one and the other.
Access granted.
Got both data stores, which were a nuke virus and a stop worm. And then, of course, I get 50 experience for the hack itself. Now, let's keep a better eye on the camera. Wait until it pans away from the door. So those lasers are automatically those lasers we would have been able to disable anyway. But I'll tell you which ones become disabled once we persuade Wayne Haas to let us in. First, this door to the morgue becomes unlocked, so we need to hack it open now. Okay, getting the data store is pretty straightforward.
Access granted.
50 XP in the data store, plus 25 for the hack. And I've got my second Praxis. So, let's go ahead and get the implanted rebreather like I wanted to. Alright, with that done, my next AUG, I think, will be the last one that I ever have to have, which is turret domination. So I'll get that next. I think that, unlike the stuff I've been getting so far, it will only take one Praxis. So that's good. Sorry, folks, I'm just clearing off an email that showed up on my phone. All right, now with that done, I think the only other hack we need to do is this one. We disable this laser system terminal. It's exactly the same as the other one we saw, so shouldn't be too terribly complicated.
Back up or else!
Uh-oh, we got spotted.
Access granted.
Don't move! Suspect is hit!
Well, I don't know where that guy came from. So I'm pretty sure the room I'm in is empty. Yeah, I do not know where that dude came from. No matter, let's try that again.
Back up, sir!
Where is he coming from?
And if, don't move!
In there? So a guy on the other side of the door is he just spawning when I start the hack? Okay, I see him now. Okay, he's coming over here. Now he's turned around. Now he's coming in here.
Stop, police!
Okay. Now I see the problem. So, let's get him on the radar, and then let's just wait for him to patrol over here and then leave. Because that hack becomes unavailable after we persuade Haas. Now let me describe the police station. If you come in without permission, and just break into the morgue and get to the neural hub without being detected, you get a ghost bonus, you get a smooth operator bonus, which is worth a total of 750, plus you get 100 experience if you go talk to Wayne Haas and actually straight up fail to convince him. So there is that option, but that's worth a total of 850 experience. All of that put together is less than the 1,000 that you get for convincing Haas to let you in. So we want to convince Wayne. That's the most experientially profitable way to do this. Oh. Hello. All right, let's just get to work on all these now.
Access granted.
Nuke virus, stop worm, 50 experience. Go ahead and shut off the lasers. And with those three hacks done, we'll head back out the same way we came in. Out to Detroit City.
Jensen, I have a message for you from one of your former colleagues, a Detective Alexander.
Jenny, what did she want?
She said she could use some help if you could make your way over to Grand River Road. And might I just add, as wonderful as it is to have you back at the office, I am not your personal dating service.
Oh, Pritchard. He's so snarky. Everybody's good. Now we will head back to the front door. And I will convince Wayne Haas to let me in.
Again to Detroit, where a handful of people were taken into custody this evening following yet another anti-augmentation demonstration. This time, patients attempting to access the Second Avenue Limb Clinic found there were blocked by supporters of the Humanity Front movement. The pro-human organization had received permission to gather in protest earlier in the week, but police decided to shut down the legal rally prematurely and closed the Broadview Tunnel. Perhaps they feared what might happen once the hostage situation at Seraph Industries resolved. Regardless, several violent skirmishes did break out, but no serious injuries were reported. This is Eliza Kassan, reporting to you live from Picus.
All right, let's turn off the TVs, because frankly, I get sick of listening to Eliza. I'm going to talk to the civilians first.
Considering all the controversy, I think the UN should regulate augmentations. Don't get me wrong. I don't agree with what those extremists did at the Seraph plant.
No.
I just think the technology could be dangerous in the wrong hands. Don't get me wrong. I don't agree with what those extremists did at the Seraph plant.
I can see you've had some
I just think the technology could be dangerous in the wrong hands.
What do you think about this augmentation debate? Looks to me like a typical power grab. Every time somebody comes up with a new idea, somebody else will want to criticize it, regulate it, or ban it completely. But really, they want to control it. Every time somebody comes up with a new idea...
That's Chet Wagner. I'm going to leave him alone for now and talk to the civilians.
It's a shame our city's name is being dragged down by fanatics. I remember when it was really bad here, back before Seraph Industries opened their doors. It's because of David Seraph and the biomod industry that Detroit is even habitable today. Of course, there are still parts of the city I won't walk through. It's because of David Seraph and the biomod industry that Detroit is even habitable today.
Considering all the controversy, of course, there are still parts I think the UN should regulate augmentation.
I always had to buy the latest, greatest techno gadgets on the market. Problem is, less than a year after he'd buy it, they'd come out with a better, faster model, and suddenly his wasn't worth the installments he was killing himself to pay. Problem is, less than a year after he'd buy it, they'd come out with a better, faster model.
Hey, how
and suddenly his wasn't worth the installments he was
killing. These offices are off limits to civilians, sir. Don't go in there.
Now wait for this guy to get off the phone to talk to him. And then we'll talk to Wayne. That'll be our second social battle. Or conversational boss fight, I think is the word they use. Okay, we've read that paper already. This guy's off the phone.
Man, this town is dead. I should have just moved to Philadelphia. They keep saying the nightlife will get better, but how many times have we heard that before? They keep saying the nightlife
will get better, but how quick many times save in case we fail.
Yeah, hang on just a sec. Shit. Jensen?
Haas. Surprised to see you here.
Aggressive, excitable, insecure.
Yeah, well, I guess you're better at looking out for yourself than I am.
I
don't have time for your self-pity. I need to get into the morgue.
That's it? Oh, forget it. I don't know what's going on with that body down there, but my orders come from the brass. No one gets in. First thing you say to me after almost 2 years is you want something?
Should I have given you an order? You've always been very good at following those.
God damn. Where do you get off being so self-righteous? You think I like this? Look at me. From SWAT team commander to a crummy desk sergeant in a two-bit precinct. I don't need this from you. I get enough of it at home. So either come up with something better than your usual attitude, or you can just forget it, because you came to me.
Has a tendency to exaggerate and escalate a situation needs to be brought back down when doing so. Feels deep remorse, is looking for absolution for something. Subject to sudden fits of rage, situation should be diffused with care. Let's absolve.
Okay, look, you're angry, and you've got a right to be. I'm putting you in a bad position, but I have to get inside that morgue. I won't let it get back to you.
I'm always in a bad position. I don't believe this. I just got my life back together and you show up. When's it gonna end? You know the moment I open that door, it's all over, right? I'll be lucky if all that happens is I get fired. Is it really that important?
I'm gonna try pleading.
Yes, your job is at risk. Yes, you've taken the blame for what happened in the past, but look, I need your help. And it's important. You got my word, whatever happens, I'll take care of you.
That's good to hear. It all comes back to the kid, doesn't it? We were given a direct order, Jensen. So I took the shot. I followed orders. He was augmented, an unknown factor. He was too much of a risk.
Again, hit him with pheromones, but... I'm gonna absolve.
We all make mistakes, Wayne. Nobody blames you for it. You have to believe that and forgive yourself, or you'll never put it behind you.
I know. It's just so hard. What could I have done different? I ask myself that every day. And then I remember what it was really about all along. You got the order. You refused it, and it got shoved onto me. I did the only thing I could do. You understand that? I just wish it could finally be over so I could live my life.
I'm gonna try crushing here.
I've heard enough of this. You're lying to yourself. You pulled that trigger, no one else. You can't escape from that for the rest of your life. Accept it, make it a part of your history, and put it in your past. Because denial is only making it worse.
I can't. Oh, hell. You're right. I've been so stupid. 2 whole years. I've got to start turning things around right now. Go on in. Don't worry about the guys. They'll leave you alone. But I need to think.
Well, there it is. 1,000 experience, silver tongue, and achievement unlocked, the desk job. Oops, that was just tab. We've earned 10 out of 49, 20%. The desk job. You convinced Wayne Haas to let you into the morgue. Well, that's handy.
Don't get me started on that liberal crap.
Give me a call in a couple of days, okay? Look, it'll be easier to cover for you if you don't hang around here too long. Look,
I don't know.
It'll be easier to cover for you if you don't hang around here too long.
Look at the force now. Our badges mean nothing. We've got no authority. Look at the force now. Our badges mean nothing. We've got no authority.
All right.
Are you supposed to be here, sir? I thought the station had been locked down. I suggest you conclude your business and get out.
Now, obviously, there's a lot to do in here. The first thing I'm going to do...
This is Eliza Kassam, reporting to you live from Pikes.
We've heard this.
The arrival of William Taggart, celebrity author and founder of the anti-augmentation organization, Humanity Front. Speaking from the tarmac at Wayne...
We've heard that already. I'm going to head straight to the basement. Take care of everything down there first. We're here. Cameras don't care now.
Are you supposed to be here, sir? I thought the station had been locked down.
This guy.
I suggest you conclude your business and get out.
This guy doesn't care either. That's good. That's good. So, here we are, right back where we were. I want to do a thorough search of this area, since I didn't last time. Alright, that's the sewer entrance. So here we are in the locker room. 10mm pistol. Reload speed upgrade. I don't think I've seen one of those. Quickfire reload upgrade kit for weapons. Use increases the weapon's reload speed. Description: the quickfire reload kit improves the breech and feed mechanisms of most handguns, rifles, and combat firearms to decrease reloading time. Manufacturer C-Tech. I think we can slot it right onto our pistol. Yes, we can. Beautiful. How's my pistol doing now? Pretty good. Still a long way to go, though. There's another pistol. There's another pistol. Combat rifle ammo. Shirts. Alright. Here we are.
About time. You the home sec guy I was ordered to wait for? Tell Manderly I didn't get the memo until I was halfway through the autopsy. By then, it was too late to close him up again.
Right. So you recovered the neural hub?
Tricky bit of work that was. A few inches lower and the bullet would have fried more than just the pedod connectors. As it is, I can't guarantee you'll get anything useful out of it, other than the fact that it's been modified.
Modified? With what?
Some kind of wet drive. But hey, I didn't look. Ultraviolet means ultraviolet, and I know how touchy you guys get when it comes to matters of national security. He's all yours. The hub's been detached, but I left it in the skull, as ordered. Now, if you'll excuse me, I got paperwork to fix.
You might have recognized the name Manderly in there. Just one of many, many tie-ins between this game and the first Deus Ex. Anyway, there's nothing here. So, here's the old dead terrorist. Let's get the brain chip.
Boss, I got the neural hub. Looks like it's been modified with some kind of wet drive. Pritchard should have a look at it.
No, don't bring it here. Frank's not finished running his diagnostic, and I don't want to risk connecting any tech to our networks till he's done.
Especially if the tech is military. So what do you want me to do?
Take the hub to your apartment. I'll have Frank contact you there.
All right. So we got the neural hub. That was worth 1,750 experience, if you weren't paying attention, which is a lot. So let's look at the brain chip. Hacker brain chip, TYM Cortec Model 76F Neural Hub, modified. The neural hub is the core processing unit for all post-human augmentation technologies. It is the gateway through which all augmentations are connected via deep brain neural command fibers, allowing the user to interface directly with their enhancements and operate them seamlessly. All augmentation users must possess a neural hub in order to function. This unit was implanted in a Purity First terrorist who attacked the Seraph Industries plant in Milwaukee Junction. It has been illegally modified with an additional solid-state protein chain data storage module known as a wet drive. Aftermarket modification of neural hub hardware is strictly prohibited under the World Health Organization's global directives for implanted technology and medicine. Alteration of these systems can result in infection by data virus, system crashes, and the inducement of cybernetic discognition disorder, CDD, also known as cyberpsychosis. That's all very interesting. So our new objective is, use my home computer to analyze the hub. I've got the neural hub, now I need to analyze it. Seraph wants me to do this in my apartment, one of the penthouse units located in the Chiron building on Grand River Road. Anyway, let's talk to this dude again. I think eventually he becomes alarmed, but...
You home sec guys really like to throw your weight around. This is the second time you've tampered with my lab, dammit. And tell Manderly if he wants to alter my paperwork again, at least get someone who can spell to do it. And tell Manderly if he wants to alter my paperwork again, at least get someone who can spell to do it.
Okay. 400 credits on that chip, plus an ebook. The Threat of Cybernetic Discognition Disorder. It's a Hudero ebook. Op-ed column in the New Cybernetics Journal, Fall 2015 edition by Hudero. Like every other new technology from the automobile to television, human augmentation has been pilloried as a menace that will destroy our society from within and reduce us all to drooling imbeciles. I'm certain that, like me, you're just as tired of this reaction to dog whistle punditry. But we can't shy away from the fact that indeed cybernetics are a double-edged sword. By making human augmentation technology free for all, we run the risk of it falling into the hands of distressed and mentally unfit individuals. There's no denying that augmentations change the way you think about yourself, but no more than one would after cosmetic surgery. And this so-called cybernetic discognition disorder seems to be little more than a convenient label slapped upon a much deeper problem. The fact is, adding cybernetic implants to your body will no more destroy your sanity than playing video games will make you a psychopath. What we must be watchful for are those whose already fragile mental states will be destabilized further by augmentation. Well, we need to hack this alarm panel, and I think he will object to that. Maybe not. He doesn't seem to care. So if I just go a downward loop, I can get to the exit and then hit the data store. Pretty easy. One stop. Should be plenty.
Access granted.
100 XP in the data store plus 75 XP for the hack. And we can disable the alarm panel. That sure is handy. Gerald Campbell seems fine with us being here. Let's hack his computer, which is a level 2. He doesn't seem to have any objection to that either. Data store up there. But we hit the adjacent node on the way to the exit anyway, so no big deal.
Access granted.
200 XP in the data store, plus 50 for the hack. From Chief of Department Timothy V. Smith, DMPD, to Dr. Gerald Campbell, ME. Reply official complaint. Jerry, I understand your concerns, but you know as well as I do that there are bigger fish trawling this pond, and we do as we are told. Your position is not in any jeopardy. Even if Penn has a problem with you, which I doubt, he has to go through me, so you're fine. The only thing that is going to threaten your position, however, is if you make a stink about that report. You wrote it, the end. If rumors to the contrary reach the wrong ears, I can't help you. Tim. I thought I should let you know I've sent a formal complaint to Captain Penn about the current lockdown. It's the second time this year, and I'm getting nervous about the solidity of my position. I've demanded that he let me know officially if he has a problem with me. In the meantime, I was wondering about my official report. Will there be one? If so, will I get to write it this time, or will I be forced to sign one already provided for me like I did 6 months ago? Gerald. From Captain Ryan Penn, DMPD. To Dr. Gerald Campbell, ME. Reply, notes. Thank you. Captain Ryan Penn, DMPD. You wrote, as you requested ASAP, here's a copy of my personal notes. It's a bit messy, please forget the lack of structure. The cause of death looks like single bullet wound to face. Get exact trajectory from lab, not recovered 10 millimeter. Brain enhancement, neural hub-like enhancement was likely designed to be concealable. Probably made in China, but highly modified. Military? Black Ops? I'll have to ask Matt. Past close, some scorching, data loss likely, TBD, Dr. Gerald Campbell, ME. Alright. Very good. Now let's get out of here. Let's head into here now. Empty jail cell. I don't think that guy's gonna come over and chat.
This ain't no zoo, you jerk. Besides, if it was, you'd be the freak everyone would come to see. Come see the Robo Boy. Half man, half machine. Step right up. Goddamn Hanser.
Sorry, baby. Can't do it through the bars. You're a horny little guy, aren't you? You're a horny little guy, aren't
you? Hey, baby. You spring me out of here, and I'll take real good care of you. Oh, don't you worry. The cops already had their go. They won't be jealous. Oh, don't you worry.
Right.
The cops already had their go. They won't be jealous.
Come see the Robo Boy.
Okay.
Half man, half machine.
Let's head in
Step
here.
Right up. Goddamn Hanser.
Hey, man. You can't just barge in here. Learn some manners, or we're gonna have a real problem here. Learn some manners. Or we're gonna have a real problem here.
Can I help you, buddy? Go talk to the front desk if you need help. Go talk to the front desk if you need help.
Okay. Let's search the drawer. We've got a concussion grenade. I'm gonna hold on to it, I think. I've decided explosives are basically always handy. Now I need to... Okay, let's search these drawers. That one's empty. There's a shotgun there. I need to hack this security hub, but I'm pretty sure these guys will get angry at me if I do. Maybe not. I got two exit nodes. So I gotta go through this one to get to the data store. I gotta go through here to get the other data store and the other exit, so.
Access granted.
Both data stores, 200 credits, 200 XP, and 50 XP for the hack. I can turn off the cameras from here, and nobody's mad at me. What a relief. Let's see what's through the vent. Ooh, 100 XP bonus. Gotta love that. And we find ourselves right back out here, One more alarm panel I need to hack. I gotta check around here for items, too. I don't think there's anything there. And I don't think there's anything here, either. An elevator. Seems a bit like overkill. I'm not gonna mess with it. But I do need to hack this alarm panel. Let's go ahead and do that. Level 3 shouldn't be too terrible. Oh, we've seen this grid already anyway. I might not have needed that stop worm. That's okay. 100 XP in the data store, 75 for the hack. I'll disable the alarm panel. And no one is the wiser. So now let's head up to the ground level. This is where things get hairy. I'll show you why.
Hear about that shipment we just got in? From Kanat Technologies?
Kanat. Oh man, you're kidding me. They're finally gonna arm us with the PEPs?
That's right, my friend. The Pulsed Energy Projection System. Single shot, non-lethal. Firing a concussive blast so strong it'll knock down an elephant. Those gangers won't even know what hit them.
About time. CPD's been using those for a year already, and we got worse problems than them.
Alright. So we need to hack all those computers, but all those cops are going to be upset if we do. So we need to take most of these guys down. As long as we don't actually get spotted, you see everyone has turned hostile, but they'll go back to being friendly if they see nothing for a long enough period of time. In the meantime, I'll go ahead and search their bodies. They're all empty. Now you'll notice that none of the cops gave us combat experience. Oh look, everyone's friendly again. That'll persist unless somebody sees something bad. Should be obvious. I don't intend to let that happen. Anyway, that's done. This hallway's clear. Here's where we would have popped out had we taken the elevator. So let's head out here. I probably should have talked to those guys before I... Oh well. We got stun gun darts.
A couple of witnesses told me they saw you throwing Molotov cocktails at the Lim Clinic building.
Nah, man. That wasn't me. I don't even know what that protest was even about.
That's funny. Because when we searched your wallet, we found a Humanity Front business card.
So what? That don't prove shit.
Listen, we got tons of punks like you pretending they're idealists while smashing windows at Lim. And someone's gonna pay for it.
Y'all didn't see me do nothing, so you can't charge me. I know my rights.
Anyway, let's check the drawer on this desk. Empty. Let's talk to everybody.
Wait your damn turn. If you want something, give your name to the desk sergeant. If you want something, give your name to the desk sergeant.
You my lawyer? You don't look like a lawyer. You look like an ad exec. You look like an ad exec.
Anyway, what we need to be careful of is...
Officer Ballard to the lobby. Officer Ballard to the lobby.
We run into trouble if the cops see us hacking, or if they see us taking any of them down, obviously. So, this is the room I've been worried about, because we need to hack all of these computers if we want to maximize our experience. I think we can get a clean takedown on this guy. And we shouldn't need to worry about it, since... Oh, somebody saw me. Like I pointed out already, none of the cops give any combat experience, so we don't need to worry about getting double takedowns, which is good.
Nah, man. That wasn't me. I don't even know what that protest was even about.
That's funny. Because when we searched your wallet, we found a Humanity Front business card.
So what? That don't prove shit.
Listen, we got tons of people smashing windows at Glenn. And someone's gonna pay for it.
Y'all didn't see me do nothing, so you can't charge me. I know my rights.
We talked to those guys already, so let's keep searching drawers. More credits. Let's talk to this guy.
Oh, now it makes sense. We're not allowed to do police work today because we're taking orders from the mayor's campaign contributor. On the other hand, getting away with murder has its advantages sometimes. Sure wish they'd let us kick ass like that once in a while. On the other hand, getting away with murder has its advantages sometimes. Sure wish they'd let us kick ass like that once in a while.
Is there something I can help you with, sir? If not, I'm sure the desk sergeant in the lobby can help.
So, you're saying your neighbor knows something about these disappearances?
Yeah. One of the boys who went missing lived in my building. They used to argue a lot with my neighbor Casey.
What did they argue about?
The boy used to listen to that conspiracy DJ, Lazarus. He used to blast that trash out of his window so the whole city could hear. Casey was always yelling at him to turn it down.
And what about that makes you think Casey is involved in his disappearance?
Well, one day, I heard the boy yelling something about Casey being a government spy. And he and the CIA were working on a plan to take over the world. The next day, the boy was gone.
Interesting.
Excuse me, but I am telling this officer something very important. You're not one of those Mason guys, too, are you?
It's a busy day. Wait your turn. I'll get to you when I can, but I guarantee it won't be today.
That's fine. Okay, I really feel like I should be able to get this guy with no trouble, but let's see.
I'm sure he was here.
Find him!
Police! Get...
That guy spotted me. Interesting. But no one saw anything when I first did the takedown. So... Maybe I just need to leave the body here. What's everybody think of that? He's got 11 credits on him, for what that's worth.
Medical examiner Campbell to the basement morgue. M.E. Campbell to the morgue.
Everybody settled down. Interesting. I'm relatively certain I need to bag this guy. So let's do that. He's got 61 credits on him. I think I can bring him over here. And I shouldn't get spotted by anybody. Oh no. I got spotted by a camera. Well, here's what I need to do. I need to make a new permasave right here. And then do what I just did and employ quick saves afterward. Let's just sit right down. Get this guy's 11 credits. Maybe I don't actually need to get that guy. But I can quick save at will. And that is an important freedom to have. It's not enough energy. Okay. I like it. 61 credits. Well, let's not get spotted by the camera this time. Let's stash him on the stairway. I think that's actually a safe place to do it. Everyone in here is still calm for now. That's good. I need to get this guy. And then those two. Before I can do any of it, of course, my takedown has to recharge. So in the meantime, let me check this stretch of hallway for stuff. Not finding any. Alright, let's quick save and let's target this guy next.
This water!
Alright, somebody saw me. I don't know who, but somebody did. Got three guys in there, one guy here. What I don't know is which guy saw me and started making a fuss. Anyway, the guy we already took down has an unlocked computer, so might as well read his mail. From Detective Jenny Alexander, DMPD, to DET87 All, Gang Report. Attention all patrol officers. The following report comes from some of our CIs and our current stakeout in Derelict Row. The D-Row ballers are packing more firepower lately. I suspect they are stockpiling it on their turf, and we are currently assessing the identity of their supplier. All of this still needs to be confirmed officially. No official clashes with the Motor City Bangers recently, but the DRBs have been attacking augmented civilians more than usual. It is my current assumption that we're on the verge of a gang war. Be careful out there, Jenny Alexander. From Captain Ryan Penn, DMPD, to DET87 All, HS Training. Hello, all. Homeland Security is finally ready to start its training courses, so next week every officer is going to have a one-on-one interview with Joseph Manderly, the go-between. Each of you will be told shortly when your meeting is scheduled. These courses are mandatory. Thank you, Captain Penn. From Captain Ryan Penn, DMPD, to DET87 All, Official Drug Policy, Attention All Personnel. Metro Police Drug Policy has been revised. Familiarize yourselves with the new sections, notably the ones regarding various legal prescription drugs now prohibited for law officers. You should all take the opportunity to review the rest of the document as well. Any questions can be directed to my office. Remember that we are required to set an example. There will be zero tolerance for transgressions, Captain Penn. That's fine. This body just makes me nervous. I want to move it, but somebody doesn't like it if I do.
Officer Sterling, call B451. Officer Sterling, call Bradbury 451.
Let me try these two. Or just the guy.
Leave me alone!
Yeah, should've known. There's actually a good chance that...
Officer Ballard to the lobby. Officer Ballard to the lobby.
There's my problem. Balcony.
Taggart.
Shut up.
Jensen, what the hell are you doing here? Station's supposed to be off limits to all non-essentials. You don't even fucking work here anymore.
That's right, off limits. I heard orders came down from pretty high up. If I had to guess, it has to do with that body in the morgue. That's right, off limits.
This guy has 97 credits. I'll take it. Now I'll get this balcony guy, who I think has been the real source of trouble for me, and I just haven't been paying attention or noticing him.
Are you supposed to be here, sir? I thought the station had been locked down. I suggest you conclude your business and get out. I suggest you conclude your business and get out.
That's exactly what I intend to do, good sir. Okay, he's got nothing. Got a pistol there. Whoop-de-doo. I'm reasonably certain no one else patrols up here, so now that he's down, maybe things will go more smoothly down here. Let's hope so. In the meantime... Whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay. Everybody went hostile just then. And I do not know why.
Take him down!
Throw down your weapon!
What is going on? Everyone is friendly, and then everyone is hostile. I don't understand. Right now, everybody's friendly. No one's discovered anything, have they? I don't think so. What is going on? Are we good? Okay, looks like we're good now. I have no idea what happened just then. But let's try this guy next. He's carrying nothing. That's no problem. Now let's try moving this body. Although, to be honest, I'd rather wait until those arrows all turn green again. This guy's not carrying anything. Okay. So far, so good.
Detective Alexander to holding area. Alexander to holding area.
If anyone's here, come out now.
I think you're seeing things.
Yep, he's seeing things, all right. He's got 52 credits. We'll drop him up here with the others. Now I'm hopeful that I can move the other body out of here, too. Just because it makes me nervous.
I'll cover you!
Nope. Still can't do that. That's fine. He was carrying a combat rifle if you want it.
You're Jensen, right? One of my buddies told me you were SWAT once upon a time. Heard you had some disagreement with the brass. Heard you had some disagreement with the press.
Let me see now. Once I've got my double takedown back, or my takedown recharged, I think I'll do a good old-fashioned DTD on these guys. Oh. No can do.
All right.
Can't bag the sleeper that way. Oh, but I unlocked a new achievement. Opportunist! I know what that one is. It is... perform 50 takedowns within the same playthrough, and civilians don't count. That's 11 out of 49, 22%. Excellent. Anyway, let's leave those gentlemen alone then. And let me try this guy. See if I can get him unscathed.
Don't kill me!
Wasn't planning on it, baby doll.
Medical examiner Campbell to the basement morgue. ME Campbell to the morgue.
Just go away! Don't kill me! Just go away!
Officer Decker, pick up line two. Decker, pick up line two.
Now, looks like we're okay. Amazingly enough. Hopeful I can now finally move all these bodies out of here. I really don't like leaving them lying out on the main floor like that. Let me see if I can get this one too.
Let's get him!
Nope. I think that last cop is actually like hearing the body slap around, so let's grab him. Now that really ought to take care of everything. He's got 34 credits. That's awesome. The two civilians don't matter. There's no ghost bonus at risk here, so we don't need to worry about that. Physics are funny, though. That's okay. Now let's see if we can finally move the last one. Yes, we can. Excellent. All right. Let's start on the computers now.
Please don't kill me.
Right here, security rating 1. P. Cadigan, password Despree.
Leave me alone.
But we'll hack.
Detective Gunn, the third floor interrogation.
Let's
please.
See.
Please don't kill me.
This is pretty straightforward. We'll just go over here and get the data store on the way.
Leave me alone!
Access granted.
150 credits plus
please.
25 XP for the
please
hack.
Don't kill me!
From Chief of Department Timothy V. Smith, DMPD, to DET-87 all. Departmental policy on augmented officers. Important. Yesterday, the DMPD released to the press our official stance on augmented and non-augmented officers within the DMPD. If there exist areas in which enhanced performance is an asset, the DMPD has no requirement that officers serving in any capacity be augmented. Any person augmented or otherwise wishing to join our ranks shall continue to be subject to the same screening and testing as everyone else. Further, no member of the DMPD shall question the ability of any other member on the basis of non-augmentation. The biannual performance evaluations reflect no bias. All officers are judged equally on merit and performance alone. Every member represents the DMPD, but whatever the individual's personal opinion may be, it does not reflect the opinion of the DMPD and is therefore to be kept private. Slurs against either augmented or non-augmented persons by members of the DMPD, whether in or out of uniform, will be severely disciplined without exceptions. All relevant policies are posted on every public board. It is the responsibility of every individual DMPD member to be familiar with these at all times. Timothy V. Smith, Chief of Department, DMPD. From Sergeant Melanie Frizzell, DMPD, to DET-87 All. Morgue lockdown. Attention all personnel. The John Doe in the morgue is classified as ultraviolet under RHS 2012. You all know the drill. Everyone with blue clearance or lower, stay out of the basement. You'll be told when it's okay to move freely again. Thank you for your attention. Sergeant Melanie Frizzell, DPMD, Acting Captain. All right. His computer was unlocked. We've already read all of those anyway. Right, have we? Yes. So let's head over here. Another security, another level one. This is Jay Champagne, password Grimster.
Officer Sterling, call B451. Officer Sterling, call Bradbury 451.
So this one's pretty straightforward. If we want the data store, we just need to loop up to here, get it, and then get the exit.
Access granted.
So we got 25 experience for the hack plus 50 experience from the data store. From Lieutenant Howard Walker, DMPD, to DET-87 All, anti-augmentation riots. Heads up, boys. Based on reports from other cities, this pro versus anti crap is only going to get worse, probably until the vote finally happens. Central wants us to stay alert for altercations between augs and non-augs and keep things from getting out of control, no matter which side you personally agree with. LW. Alright. Let's head over here. This one's unlocked. We've read all those already. So let's go to the center one. Level 1, hack. H. Ellison, password, Cordwainer. Same grid we just did. Awesome.
Access granted.
50 XP in the data store, 25 XP for the hack. We've already read all those emails. We've already read this unlocked one. This one is, I'm sure, level one. They're all level one. Same grid. All right, let's do it.
Medical examiner Campbell to the basement morgue. ME Campbell to the morgue.
Access granted.
50 XP in the data store, 25 XP for the hack. From Kent Nashel, DMPD, to Robin Deckard, DMPD, basement hub. Hey, for the next shift, they've changed the basement cam hub's login for the new guy. Login, impost, password, blues. They weren't able to change the code for the laser grid, though, because apparently they need the captain's clearance for that, and he ain't there. Take care, Kent. From XXRoyXX at gaggle.det.usa to Robin Deckard, DMPD. Reply, favor. Come on, man, you gotta let me borrow it. You owe me a favor, Roy. You wrote, sorry. XXRoyXX at gaggle.det.usa wrote, yeah, but it's lame. Yours is more of a pleasure model, if you catch my drift. You wrote, you already have a car. XXRoyXX at gaggle.det.usa wrote, hey man, this is not easy to ask, and I know you're probably going to say no, but I'd really appreciate if you could let me borrow your Pris coupe for the weekend. I'm taking Anna to the country. Roy. Anyone who's seen Blade Runner should have recognized a lot. First, the login, R. Deckard, is Harrison Ford's character. And then Roy and Pris are both characters in Blade Runner, and I think Anna might be too, but I don't remember that for sure. Anyway, that was a very straightforward, easy hack. This one's unlocked. I don't know if they're going to get mad at me or not, but... oh, gosh. I think I just remembered a pretty big problem. Let me load back the main save. The problem is that those computers are hackable, if I remember right. So, let me get this guy, since all he's going to do is be in the way. Get his 61 credits. Well, that was easy enough. Let me check the bathrooms, although I'm relatively certain there's nothing in here. Nope, nope, nope. This one. Same. Nothing. These offices are both hackable. I'll get to that. What I need to do is pull those guys off their computers without taking them down, which could actually be pretty tough.
That didn't sound right.
Well, he's over there. See? Yeah, we can hack this.
What happened here?
I don't like this at all.
Leave me alone!
Maybe what I can do is get them, pull them all out of the room and then just hack everything that way.
Please don't kill me!
That'd make things easy, wouldn't it? If I can just make it work.
Leave me alone! Please!
Lieutenant,
please don't kill me!
Lieutenant, Infodake, line 3.
This area is restricted.
See, they don't like it if I hack, so I need to get them out of the room.
Leave me alone!
Maybe once I pull them off the computers, it's okay to take them down.
Please, please don't kill me.
Now that I've got them up and searching. And just pull them somewhere useful. Well, their computers are all locked, and they're all standing still, so now maybe I can do something. But of course, now they're all facing each other. Let me see what I can do. I think they have to be unable to see me when I make the throw. Or something. Not that simple either. Oh, but he came out here. Let's see what that does for me. Dang it. That was exactly what I didn't want to have happen. I still gotta go get the guy on the second floor anyway. I'm gonna do that right quick.
Found their route blocked by supporters of the Humanity Front movement. The pro-human organization had received permission to gather in protest earlier in the week, but police decided to shut down the legal rally prematurely and closed the broadcast.
Right. By the way, 100 experience for that vent. So that's nice. Well, if he goes back out here, I should be able to take him down and move him into the vent. Because you'll notice, right now, none of these computers are unlocked. We can get experience for hacking them all, which is, of course, what we want to do. Yes, all 9 of these can be hacked. That's what we need. Tag this one again. Maybe now that the door is closed, we'll be able to move the body. Be easiest to pull it into the vent. Now we can just leave it in the bathroom. Perfect. And I'll close the bathroom door. Now I need to make sure that I can't remember which station was his, but it doesn't matter. They're both still locked. That's what I was really hoping for. Okay, sorry we have to repeat this little exercise, folks, but you want maximum experience? That's the kind of thing you gotta do. So, we got a computer in there. Got a security hub behind Haas. Two doors. Here's the alarm panel. Those are two doors. Security hub is behind Haas. Okay. Let me think about what to do next. These guys are all in each other's line of sight, so need to do something to make him suspicious. Gonna drag one of these bodies close enough to pull the couch guy out of the... Close enough to pull the couch guy out like I did last time. Unless I can just make everybody suspicious this way again. Doesn't look like that's happening. I'm pretty confident that this can work. I just need to be more careful. Turn around sooner. There we go. Now let's leave the body here.
If anyone's here, come out now.
I think you're seeing things.
I think you're seeing things too, bud. Punch. He's got 52 credits. Let's drag him up here with the others. All right, that's one less to worry about. Maybe what I need to do is hit somebody with one of the boxes. Nope, that didn't do it. I better go take care of the second floor balcony guy. Before I mess with those dudes anymore. Shut up, Eliza. Okay. So far, so good. Now, maybe I can pull one of these. Maybe I can pull one of these guys out the same way. Just drag a body into visual range. Yep. I didn't think that was going to go so well. Maybe I need a gunshot. That works. Often. Let's get out of sight. Pull the trigger once. Holster it.
Please don't kill me.
I can go ahead and drop the rifle.
Police!
Oh no. Apparently they didn't like me. What they didn't like was Jensen pulling out his gun, because when I told him to drop the combat rifle, he decided to be helpful and pull out his pistol. Anyway. There we go. That's what I wanted. Everybody's checking things out where they heard the shot.
Please,
better keep my eyes open.
Don't kill me.
Something strange is going on.
Wait, I do want to drop the combat rifle. I'd like to holster the pistol as well, Jensen. If you can manage that.
Kill me. Leave me alone.
Nope, just keep spinning around, guys. No problem. No problem.
Please. Please don't kill me.
What I need is for one to move out of sight of the others. Just one. Ah, dang. Say, if I could just get him out of the way while that guy's back was turned, we'd be fine, but now they're facing each other.
Please, please don't kill me. Leave me alone.
Okay, let's try again. Okay, he's got combat rifle ammo. Now everybody's settled down. How about that?
You're Jensen, right? One of my buddies told me you were SWAT once upon a time.
Oh, crap. I saved. Shit. I lost a hack. Gonna have to start all over again. Damn it. This is such a pain in the ass. Sorry, folks. All right. I think I have a solution, though. Well, pistol's not gonna cut it. I need a different gun. I'm pretty sure this guy just has a pistol, but I'll take his credits. I'll stash his body in the stairwell. And I'll quick save again. Shut up, Eliza. Dum-dum-dum. I gotta admit, I don't know why these guys don't like boxes, but they don't. I'm gonna go get second floor guys. Starting with you. And your 97 credits. Everyone is still on alert. Wh- which is fine and dandy by me, but... my action hasn't recharged yet.
Leave me alone.
What, is the guy in the way? Is that why we can't close the door? Apparently. Let me get the other second floor guy then. With this particular recharge. He's carrying nothing. Alright, well, apparently everyone is settled now. So they're gonna assume their standing positions.
Medical examiner Campbell to the basement.
I might be approaching this the wrong way. I know I can take this guy out of the picture, and I'm gonna do that. Then, it may be simpler than I think. That happens a lot. I might just be approaching this in the wrong way. We'll see. Let's wait for him to go into the hallway and then turn him into a non-issue. Get the 100 experience again. Always useful. There we go. Pull him into the bathroom, which is now quite handily closed. How he ended up inside the stall, I don't know, but that's a fine place for him to be.
Area seems clear.
Oh, I was hoping he'd stay in here.
Wait your damn turn!
Go this way. Not going to, huh? No, he's pretty determined to head back to his post. Unfortunately. But I think I can use the other body to pull him into the hallway and take him out of the picture, which can only help. So let's do exactly that. Different one. Same result. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Alright. Now this I might be able to work with. Let's see. I gotta make sure all the computers are still locked. I'm reasonably sure they are. Excellent.
Lieutenant Infodake, line 3. Lieutenant Infodake, line 3.
Now, of course, I should be able to get the other guy to come in here again, just like I did last time. Oh, too slow. That's okay, though. This is finally going to work. I know it. I know it. I know it. Oh, let's bring a body with me, since they've been such handy tools so far. There. Now he's going to come to the hallway.
anyone's here, come out now.
Should be able to close the door behind him. Give him a nice, solid whack. That leaves only one guy out there. Only one who's a threat, anyway. The two civilians really don't matter at all. And now, maybe I can get the other guy to come in here, too. That would sure make things simple. Perfect. That is exactly what I was hoping for.
Anyone's here? Come on now!
Later, bro. Alright, now with him down, this area is clear. I didn't have to mess with any of these guys. These guys aren't in a panic. And I should be able to hack all 9 computers like I originally wanted to. That one is locked. I gotta check all the ones guys were working at. That one is locked. That one is locked. And that one is locked. And that, my friends, is worth a new permasave, because that was annoyingly hard to pull off. So, with that done, let's start hacking. This one I'm still worried about, if only because that guy in there might be upset at me, but P. Dick, password Electro Lamb. Never you mind, we're hacking. Looks like he can't see. Good. So, all roads to the data store lead through the transfer node, which is fine. Let's open the way to the exit first. Now let's hit the transfer. I can get this one for free, so why not? Now let's just go to the data store. Got the data store.
Access granted.
Got the exit. So the data store was 200 XP plus 25 for the hack itself. Now anything I've already read to you, I won't repeat reading, so we've seen all those. And nobody got upset. Good. That's what I wanted. Let's get this one next. B. Sterling, password investor. Never mind. Hack, hack, hack. Okay. Yeah, I've seen this one too. It's also very straightforward. Come on. Adam! I did not want you to waste your stop worm on that. I hate how clunky the hacking interface can be.
Officer Decker, don't kill me! Decker, pick up line two.
Let's try this again. This time,
please,
just capture. Don't waste a stop worm.
Access granted.
All right. 150 credits plus 25 XP for the hack.
Kill me.
We've seen all those emails already. So next computer. R. Deckard, password unicorn. The password is another Blade Runner reference, by the way. Although I'm sure most of you knew that.
Access granted.
50 XP from the data store plus 25 from the hack. Next computer. 6 more to go out here on the floor. B. Bethke, password Maverick.
Officer Sterling, call B451. Officer Sterling, call Bradbury 451.
Access granted.
Got the data store, 200 XP, plus 25 for the hack. And we've already seen all those emails. Perfect. Five to go. H. Ellison, password Cordwainer.
Access granted.
50 XP from the data store, plus 25 from the hack. And we've already seen all the emails. Four to go. Jay Ballard, password Soul Empire.
Just go away.
Seen this board already.
Access granted.
150 credits plus 25 XP for the hack. And
away.
We've seen the emails. Three computers left. Then we're done on the floor, at least. Jay Champagne, password Grimster. No thanks, we'll hack.
Detective Alexander to holding area.
Of course, we've seen this board already. It's extremely straightforward.
Access granted.
50 XP from the data store, plus 25 for the hack. And we've seen the emails. Two to go. W. Gibson, password Baron Null. But we will hack instead.
Medical examiner Campbell to the basement floor.
Access granted.
200 from the data store, plus 25 for the hack. And I've got another Praxis. We've already read these emails, but with the Praxis, I'm going to go ahead and get turret domination. And that's it. I am now at least capable of getting everything in the game. Next, I'm going to get things that are useful. The next thing I'm going to get is Punch Through Wall, which will only cost one Praxis. So that'll be next. Let's get the last computer here on the floor. P. Cadigan, password Despree. Anyway, we've seen the board already, I think. Yes, we have. It's one of the more straightforward ones.
Access granted.
150 credits, 25 experience, and we've already seen all the emails. So, with that, let's head out here. Gonna hack the door on this office, which is level 2. It's also pretty darn straightforward.
Access granted.
I got a stop worm and 50 experience for the hack. Now the door is open. Coming in here is worth another 200 experience. And then I want to hack the computer. This is M. Frazel. This computer's level 2. So, let me look at this grid because it looks complicated. It is complicated. Looks like I've got two data stores. And the exit. Both data stores are available now, and so is the exit, so let's get moving. First data store, second data store, and exit.
Access granted.
250 credits, 250 experience from the data store, plus 50 experience for the hack. From Captain Ryan Penn, DMPD, to Sergeant Melanie Frizzell, DMPD, office code. Sergeant, I will not be in the building for the next 3 days. I am now being unexpectedly sent to that conference in San Diego, Police and Corporate Security, Methods, Integration, and Best Practices. In the event of emergency, you may gain access to my office with the code 2419. I trust you to use your discretion as to what constitutes sufficient emergency. I further trust your discretion as to which of your other desk sergeants should have this code. A maintenance team is scheduled to come in and fix hiccups in the ventilation system. You will have to turn off the security grid. Code is 7668. I can be reached in San Diego by calling the Hotel Palma, Captain Penn. Interesting. Now let's check out this room. Pocket Secretary. New kid in the armory, from Captain Ryan Penn, DMPD, to Sergeant Melanie Frizzell, DMPD. Sergeant, they've sent us Nicefield from Ormstown Division. Kid's got friends in high places. They want him safe inside until he's got enough time in for a promotion. He's gonna be the one in charge of the armory. Please give him the details. Here's his login info. Login F Nicefield, password patriotism. Thank you. Captain Ryan Penn, DMPD. Alright, let's get rid of all the new tags. All right. What else is in here? There's a credit chit on the desk, which I'm looking for. Looking at, rather. Just having trouble getting Jensen to want to grab it. 250 credits. It's a big credit chip. And inside the drawer, a 10mm pistol. That. Let's hack the reception door. It's another level 2 device. But it has a fairly simple grid.
Access granted.
Just a stop worm and 50 experience for the base hack. Now, I need to head in here. And I need to you get 200 experience for getting into the reception area. Now I need to hack the security hub, but the camera will get upset with me.
I heard there was a demonstration at the limb.
And so will that other cop, if I remember right.
Listen, I can't promise anything. Not right now.
Well, let me see.
All right, then. Bye.
Don't take another step. Back away, now.
Yeah, well, he doesn't like it, so we're gonna have to get rid of him for sure. So, I might as well go ahead and do that. Shouldn't be too complicated. Leave him in here with all of his buddies from the floor. Now, if I wait for the camera to sweep, I ought to have enough time to take care of it. Of course, it's a big board.
Eliza mentioned. I've seen.
It's got 4 data stores, but I can get all of them right away. And then just go for the exit.
Access Access granted.
100 credits, 100 XP, nuke virus, stop worm.
What's up?
And I can turn off the camera.
No.
Perfect.
There was a demonstration at the limb clinic.
That's all I needed. Now let's check things out in here.
Don't get me started on that liberal crap.
Painkillers in the trash can. I think that's it, so we're done here. I had to use a couple of my nuke viruses, but that's not really a big deal. Finally, we've got the alarm panel. So let me hack that too. One data store over there, and really only one way to get to it. It's gonna be tough though.
Access granted.
One nuke virus, 75 experience. We'll disable the panel. And that'll be that. So now let's go talk to Officer Wagner.
Yeah? What do you want?
Information.
Then go bother the receptionist, Chrome Boy, instead of wasting my goddamn time.
Not that kind of information. I want to know about the Seraph Industries case.
Ha ha! And I want a blowjob and a vintage 05 Bard GT, so I guess we both keep on dreaming. Huh? Metalhead?
Let's ask for info.
I know you handled the critical evidence linked to the case, and I want to know about it.
First off, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. And second, even if I did, what makes you think I give a shit about what you want? Now, I strongly suggest you take your high-tech, toaster-looking ass out of my way before I handle you.
Okay. So, we got 100 XP for meeting with Officer Wagner. Next is obtain information from Officer Wagner. Chet Wagner knows more than he wants to admit about the investigation into Megan's murder. I've got to find a way to change his mind. That's pretty straightforward. So for now, we're done here, so let's head up to level 2. Credit chip on the floor, 69 credits, awesome. Over in these shelves, there's an ebook. Global Politics Review, 2026 edition, Chapter 5, The European Quagmire. With America's attentions increasingly focused on internal problems, its withdrawal from NATO and the subsequent dissolution of that military political entity had left Europe without its primary overseas ally and a vacuum that the European Union has struggled to fill. The creation of a replacement for NATO, the European Common Defense Alliance, ECDA, while far-reaching, remains mired in bureaucratic red tape. Ranged against an increasingly aggressive Russian Federation, the European Union is split between the hawks and the doves who wish to either defang or appease the reawakening bear. While trying hard to maintain an outward sense of accord, lines of dissent and old rivalries simmer just below the surface across mainland Europe, threatening to make themselves apparent. Tensions over economic factors and the tissue-thin border controls between nations are stressing the bonds between the EU nations toward the breaking point. Interesting. Up here, that restricted area is the armory, but here is Captain Penn's office. So, there's plenty to do. First, I just want to show you that this is the entrance slash exit from the fire escape. 301 credits on a chip right there. That's pretty awesome. I don't think there's anything else out in this hallway. Nope, 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 nope. So we've got Lieutenant LeBeef's office, Captain Penn's office, and the armory. I think I'll start with the vent. Okay. $200 XP explorer bonus, $300 XP for locating Captain Penn's office. Now, our objective changed. Investigate Captain Penn's computer. If someone ordered Penn to bury the case, there's a good chance I'll find proof on his computer. And if he's followed station protocol, his computer is going to be locked. Now, before I mess with the computer, let's hack the outside door. Level 2 device. I've got the code, but of course we're gonna hack. Why wouldn't we? So no real point in going left. Let's just head right, clear the way to the exit, and then get the data store as soon as we can. All is well. One stop worm plus 50 experience. Alright. Now, here we are in Captain Penn's office, but let's go ahead and hack the door to Lieutenant LeBeef's office, too. Alright, no data stores. I just have to get to the exit, which is pretty straightforward. Should be fine.
Access granted.
50 experience for the hack. That's beautiful. Now... Let's slice Captain Penn. Well, let's search his office. On the desk, we find 10mm pistol and pistol ammo in the drawer. There's a pocket secretary. Morgue access from Dr. Gerald Campbell, ME, to Captain Ryan Penn, DMPD. Captain, in keeping with RHS protocol, I've changed the entry code for the morgue. For the duration of the morgue lockout, the interim code will be 9212. As soon as access has been restored to all personnel, the former code will be restored and you will be so advised. Thank you, Dr. Gerald Campbell, ME. Well, that's interesting. There's a e-book, Hearts of Steel, In the Dawn. The morning light through the windows was rich like the colors of autumn. Meredith lay in it, a snarl of sheets around her body, Jace's arm, the steel arm, across her bare thigh like a discarded weapon. She traced up the cyber limb and across the place where metal met flesh, the seam of the join, rough and tanned. Jace stirred and awoke, his craggy face softened. What's wrong? Meredith felt a peculiar mix of sadness and elation, a tightness in her chest as if she were on the verge of tears. I was afraid you might hurt me. He was shocked. Mary, no, I would never. She wanted to look away, but she couldn't. I don't know what I'm feeling. He took her by the hand, out of the bed, up and across to the window. I do, he said, bringing her lips to his. 269 credits on the credit chip. Here's a laser system terminal, which we will, of course, hack, despite knowing the code. Let's go this way so we can get the data store on our way to the exit.
Access granted.
Nuke virus and 50 experience. And I'll shut down the lasers. With that done. to move into LaBeef's office, but it looks like the vent actually goes all the way up to the third level. That looks like the armory. Yeah, I need to find a few things. 200 XP explorer bonus for LaBeef's office. That's all well and good. Okay. All is well. So now, here in Captain Penn's office, I'm settled. Let's go ahead and hack the computer. Exit's down there. Data store over there.
Access granted.
200 credits in the data store, 50 experience for the hack. From J. Manderly at gov.sec.net to Captain Ryan Penn, DMPD, UV. Captain, following the recent incident at Seraph Industries, the body of an unidentified male terrorist was delivered to your morgue. You are hereby advised that this corpse has been classified ultraviolet under the revised Homeland Security Act, 2012. In keeping with Article 7, Section 3, under no circumstances is the corpse to be transferred to the city morgue. It must remain in your own facilities until my people arrive to take possession. Pursuant to this, per Section 4, all persons of blue clearance or lower are denied access to your morgue. The medical examiner may remain on site, of course, to keep the body isolated, but there is to be no, repeat, no autopsy performed. These measures will be in place until I deliver the all clear. Thank you for your understanding in this matter. Joseph Manderly, Advisor to the Deputy Administrator, National Preparedness. From Dr. Gerald Campbell, ME, to Captain Ryan Penn, DMPD, Morgue Procedures. Sir, today marks the second time this year when I have been prevented from doing my job following an attack on Seraph Industries. If there exists some question about my skill level, my ability to be discreet, or the way I run my lab, I demand it be brought to my attention immediately. Professional courtesy requires a proper explanation. Dr. Gerald Campbell, ME. From Homeland Security Criminal Database to Captain Ryan Penn, DMPD. Query number 08016, Zeke Sanders. Zeke Sanders, El Gato Ezequiel Sandoval, 1990, Los Angeles, California, Paolo and Conception, three siblings, 5 foot 10 inches, 175 pounds. Features: Hispanic, missing left eye, military tattoos, including USMC sigil. USMC Afghanistan, wounded, medical discharge. Re-enlisted under Recycle Military Program, operations classified. Discharged under Cessation Act. Attack on civilians in Glendale Shopping Complex, Los Angeles. 13 injuries, no fatalities, siege and hostage situation. Diagnosed on-site as post-traumatic acute dissociation. Remanded into medical custody. Neuroprosthetic Rehabilitation Center near Camp Topaz, Utah. Declared cured 6 months later and released. Criminal activities. Leader of anti-augmentation domestic terrorist group claiming responsibility for numerous acts of breaking and entering, vandalism, theft, arson, targets all associated with augmentation industry. MO of attacks consistently involves empty buildings with minimal security personnel, no fatalities, outstanding warrants, should be considered armed and extremely dangerous. That completes Investigate Captain Penn's computer, worth 750 experience. From J. Manderly at gov.sec.net to Captain Ryan Penn, DMPD. Over and done. Captain, due to the present sensitive context, it is our recommendation that case TA00514 regarding the terrorist attack on Seraph Industries be filed and closed ASAP. In our opinion, the conclusions proposed at this stage of the investigation are quite satisfactory. I have appointed a state medical examiner to perform the autopsies on the victims. This is a critical situation, and we must try to keep the information contained as tightly as possible. I am certain you understand the public relations nightmare this incident implies, and will act promptly and accordingly. Have your men reassigned by the end of the day. Joseph Manderly, Advisor to the Deputy Administrator, National Preparedness. Interesting. Let's head into Lieutenant LaBeef's office. First, let's see what we can find. Nothing on the desk. In the drawers, there's 134 credits and two shotgun cartridges. Over here, find nothing. There's a shotgun hiding right there, and a pocket secretary right here. Jenny Alexander's office, from Adrian Virgos, DMPD, to Lieutenant Clayton LaBeef, DMPD. Here you go, sir. The access code to Jenny Alexander's office is 3727. Adrian Vargos, IT technician, DMPD. All right. That's all well and done. So, let's hack this bad boy. See LaBeef, no code found. That's fine. Now, we've got two data stores. Which are actually gonna be tough to get to.
Access granted.
But we got him. 100 credits, 150 XP, plus 50 XP for the hack itself. From Detective Jenny Alexander, DMPD, to Lieutenant Clayton LaBeef, DMPD. Weapon stockpile. Sir, I think I've got a lead on a D-Row Baller's weapons stash. One of the people I've gotten close to was bragging about a hidden space under the floor of an old ruined building deep in Derelict Row. I know we've discussed this before, but I strongly suggest you reconsider your decision about letting me move in for a closer look. As a matter of fact, I doubt we can afford to wait much longer. Detective Jenny Alexander, DMPD. From DETWKS0012@sec.fema.net to Lieutenant Clayton LaBeef, DMPD. Gang activity. Clay. I've been seeing more and more of those augmented gangers encroaching on our security perimeter. They keep it up, and the general public may get wind of what's really going on in here. Jackie's gonna be in touch. Give him whatever help he needs. Ooh. Intrigue. Anyway, I'm gonna head through the vent now. Go ahead and take this guy down. I'll listen to Lazarus in earnest later. Alright. I'd better hack the security hub now just to shut down the camera. Three data stores, 1, 2, 3, and two exit nodes.
That's right, Billy, you gullible little bastard. You will be put in a camp for an indeterminate amount of time,
okay.
Billy.
Get comfy, kids. I think I know how I want to go about this.
Access granted.
All right, I got them all. 100 credits, 150 XP, a nuke virus, plus 75 XP for the hack. Let's turn off the cameras to start with. Now that we're in. Guess I'll just go ahead and open the door, but
the mother from Florida confirmed what most of us already know, but I want to share it with you anyway. They're doing drills. FEMA is doing drills with our children and not even telling us. They're taking our kids to these secret camps that have been springing up everywhere across the country and not even telling the parents. But what are these drills for? Well, they're to introduce them to the future. REX-84 is the future. The ADEX list is the future. They're saying, here you go, children.
happens when you speak up against corruption, Teddy. This is what you get for demanding the truth, Georgie. This is what happens when you don't lie down and take it in the ass from the international banking cartel, Tracy. And you don't follow the biased doctrine of Pikus and their slut puppet Eliza Kazan, Billy. That's right, Billy, you gullible little bastard. You will be put in a camp for an indeterminate amount of time, Billy. Get comfy, kids.
Anyway, let's hack this second laser terminal now. Even though we've already disarmed the lasers at the other one, we, of course, want the experience.
Access granted.
Nuke virus, 50 experience. Laser system's already inactive, which is all we want. 200 XP explorer bonus for coming into the armory. Now we've got combat rifles, we've got shotguns, a rate of fire upgrade, which I think I'll read about. Standard rate increment upgrade package for weapons. Use increases the number of bullets fired per second. Description: the rate increment upgrade optimizes the trigger and firing mechanisms of most handguns, rifles, and combat firearms, thereby increasing their cyclic rate of fire. Manufacturer: Kaiga LTD. Perfect. Put it on my pistol. Love it. How we doing? Awesome. Now here we have a mine template and two more concussion grenades. This is the first mine template, so let me show you what that does. Mark 87 Tactical Munition Mine Template, TMMT. Use: combine with a grenade to create a mine of the same type. Activation: combine both the grenade and the mine template within the inventory. Description: the Mark 87 TMMT is a user-deployed, battlefield-configurable, multifunction landmine for use in anti-personnel, anti-material, or distraction operations. It can be combined with any standard grenade type, fragmentation, EMP, concussion, or gas, to create a situation-specific static munition. To activate it, the operator must combine the template base module with any standard grenade type before deploying it to a target location. Once initiated, the mine's built-in vibrational and atmospheric sensors will trigger a fused detonation on the approach of any threat vector. Manufacturer: Steiner Bisley GmbH. I'll hold on to that for now. Now here is a PEPS, which I actually do want to hold on to. I'll explain why after I read about it. PEPS, Pulsed Energy Projection System, aka PEPS. Use: knock down multiple opponents at once, may result in targets falling unconscious. Description: an experimental weapon design recently introduced to the marketplace, the Pulsed Energy Projection System is a single-shot, non-lethal firearm capable of generating an immensely powerful conical blast wave of concussive force that will knock down enemy combatants and displace smaller medium-weight objects in its firing range. It is most often used in military scenarios where threat forces must be disarmed and casualties kept to a minimum. Bear in mind, however, that the weapon has a long firing cycle, a short operational range, and a lengthy reload time. Upgrades: the PEPS does not support standard upgrade packages. Manufacturer: Connaught Technologies. Let's get the PEPS energy packs too. PEPS energy pack: smart cell pulsed energy charge pack. Description: a military specification double vial binary magazine containing a fluid matrix and liquid nitrogen cooling chamber, and manufactured exclusively for use as ammunition in the Connaught Technologies pulsed energy projection system, PEPS. Manufacturer: Bobson Synthetics Group. Now, we want the PEPS both because it's a terrific non-lethal weapon, but we can also use it to move heavy objects around without having to take the lift throw heavy objects augmentation, which ends up being pretty handy. There's one thing left to do on level 2, which is just to hack this alarm panel. So let's do it. One data store. Getting to it is really pretty straightforward, it's just annoying. Yeah, this isn't happening. Not even close. Let's try again. I can't be detected on my very first node. Or I'm gonna have a bad time. Hey, let's try this again.
Access granted.
Alright, we got the stop worm and 75 experience for the hack, and I'll disable the alarm panel. Beautiful. Okay. We should be just about set now. Let's head up to level 3. Detective offices to the left and right.
Is there something I can help you with, sir? If not, I'm sure the desk sergeant in the lobby can help.
I'm just a fan of having these guys not moving around. Just seems safer that way. I'll leave him there. Up to the left, we've got what looks like a holding room. I know they're interrogating someone in there. I won't go in there yet. Let's go to the right first. Got a vent there. There's a camera, an alarm panel, another vent, another cop, Detective McCann, Detective Gum, Detective Wagner, Detective Murphy, Detective Alexander. And this, I think, ultimately takes us out to the roof. Let me start there. 100 experience. If I go up the ladder, I'm relatively certain this is the roof access. Yep, exit to Detroit City. Still not ready for that. Gotta clean out level 3. And then, of course, after we get some dirt on the good Officer Wagner, we need to go back down and interrogate him before we're done with anything. You'll notice this camera's panning faster than most of them do. But should still be able to take this guy down. He had 131 credits and a pocket secretary. Third floor offices from Adrian Virgos, DMPD, to Christopher Trott, DMPD. Hey, Sergeant Frizzell wanted to make sure I give you the codes to all the third floor offices for your round. 3727 6065 4523 2231 0548 0426. Adrian Virgos, IT technician, DMPD. Well, awesome. Well, this is weird. Something's not working right. Yeah, it's not letting me look at anything else. How weird. Anyway, camera over there. Let's hustle down here. Stash him in the stairwell with the other guy. Now I should be relatively free to do as I will. First things first, I want to hit Officer Wagner's office, which is the middle one here on the left. I'll just hack my way in. Oh, we've seen this grid before. No problem.
Access granted.
Okay, we got 150 credits plus 25 experience for the hack. Locate Officer Wagner's office is complete. That's 300 XP. Now we have investigate Officer Wagner's office. What does it say there? There has to be something inside Wagner's office that I can use to convince him to talk to me. Better look around carefully until I find it. Alright, well, inside the desk drawers, we've got 3 credit chips, 50 each. There's nothing on the desk. Not messing with the vents just yet. Okay, let's tap his computer. Wow.
Back up or else.
Whoa. Who's looking at me? Who's mad? Okay, well, I guess I'd better shut the door and then try the hack. Alright. I don't think it's actually as complicated as it looks. Because for all the spray underneath, you'll notice that all that's connected to me are these 4. The exit and the red. So, let's just head for the exit. No data store to find here at all.
Access granted.
We're in. A mere 25 experience for that. From Detective Fred Moyse, DMPD, to Detective Chet Wagner, DMPD. Insight. Hello, Detective Wagner. I'm a colleague at the 76th Precinct, and it has come to my attention that you were one of the investigators on the Seraph Industries attack a couple months ago. I'm currently assigned to the Seraph Manufacturing Plant case. I'm sure you were aware of the recent attack. I'd really like to meet with you and get your input on your investigation. See if we can cross-reference evidence, interviews. I'll be looking to receive word from you. Cordially, Detective Fred Moyse, DMPD. From 011452 at gaggle.det.usa to Detective Chet Wagner, DMPD, thank you. Just a quick message to thank you for your help in the Seraph Industries investigation. You helped us handle a delicate situation. We won't forget this. There it is. Investigate Officer Wagner's office complete, 750 XP. From Blaine and DeBrain at scowlingmask.net to Detective Chet Wagner, DMPD, we got a problem. Fuck you, man. Fuck you. You wrote. Are you fucking retarded? What? Do you also want to come paint a giant fucking billboard on my lawn that says I associate with drug dealers? They could be screening my inbox, you dumb fuck. Never ever leave written evidence, stupid fucking bastard. Anyway, grow some fucking balls, Lopes. Do I have to do everything? Blaine and DeBrain at scowlingmask.net wrote, yo man, we got a motherfucking problem, bro. Some of them cats we stomped near the turf in City A are still coming around. I thought we had a deal, man. I let you in on the profit, but you have to keep them fucks out of my way so I can make the extra cheese dealing the stuff in the first place. Interesting. Let's take a little break and just go ahead and go talk to Officer Wagner. Back down on level 1. Then I'll bounce back up here and finish my explorations properly. All right, Chet.
I heard there was a demonstration at the limb clinic.
Are you deaf or just plain stupid? I told you to get the hell out of my way.
Ask for info.
Strong words. You're a real poet. Tell me, is that how you plan to handle the judge when they prosecute you for perjury, possession, and intent to distribute?
What the hell are you babbling about, Chrome Boy?
Funny story. There's this guy, Blaine Lopez. Deals dope near City Airport. A real scumbag. You know him? Because I have a nice little chat record between him and you. So you want to go to jail? Or you want to tell me what I want to know?
How the hell do you... Shit, man. Now listen. I just did what was asked of me. I didn't have a choice.
Talk.
Okay, look. I just came in one morning and there was an email with my new assignment in it. Official business. But there were also specific instructions. I had to check out the lab for footage from an Intellicam. They told me to take it and leave it near a garbage can somewhere near the lake.
What was on it?
Well, it's not crystal clear, but mainly it shows the boys who attacked Seraph as they were breaching the labs. And it looked like they were bringing something in with them. Impossible to tell what.
Who asked you to do this?
You think I know? Orders are orders around here. They always come from above. And nobody asks questions. You just do what they say, and you hope you don't end up like Secretary Haas over there.
Obtain information from Officer Wagner is complete. That's 300 XP, and we got a praxis point. So I'm going to go ahead and get Punch Through Wall. Awesome. What do I want next? Okay. I think next I want jump enhancement, which takes two. So holding out for two again, which is fine. Let's head back upstairs now. So we're not done checking out level three. Two more doors to hack. Before I even do that, though, I got these guys to deal with. I need to pull him off the computer, too, so... Dang it. I was hoping I could alarm him that way. Wait a minute. I have a peps. Which I think... Let me make a new permasave so I can be sure about this, but... I can... take down his buddy here.
Who's there?
Then I can get my peps equipped. And I ought to be able to just shoot the guy. Now, is that awesome? I submit that the answer is yes. Pistol ammo, la-di-da. This one's got nothing. But his computer is locked, which is what you want, because if you knock him out while he's on it, his computer's unlocked. There may be a smoother way to do that, though. Let me see. You can almost always get these guys. Just with noise or something like it. Well, since he's got pistol ammo, it'd be nice if I could just use my pistol.
What's that?
Well, that's sufficient to pull his buddy out of his chair. The guy I need to pull out is him.
Someone's running.
Okay, good, good. Alarmed is good. Now, if I can just keep him off of his computer. It's showing him still on it. Why is he still on it? This does not make sense. So if I take him down now, the computer will just be unlocked. which I don't want.
Nice digs. You ever heard of this 80s movie? Anyone ever tell you you got that movie star look about you? Anyone ever tell you you got that movie star look about you?
Vodka? Well, I haven't seen that yet, so let's examine it at least. Extreme Crimson Premium Vodka. Use: gain an additional 20 health points up to a maximum of 200. Activation: used from the inventory. Description: Extreme Crimson is a traditional potato distilled vodka with absolutely no hint of fruit, citrus, or otherwise. That's extreme. That's Extreme Crimson. Warning: alcoholic beverages will imbue the drinker with a small increase in damage resistance. Each additional beverage consumed will increase this effect. Adverse effects will include blurred vision. Alright, tell you what. We're gonna go with the first solution I used. Because it worked just fine. See, now they're both down. I can hack the computer just like I wanted. So, let's get in there. Around the office, I'm not finding anything. Oh, let's just do the hack. Alright, what do we have here? Pretty straightforward, actually. Get the clearance, get the data store, hit the exit.
Access granted.
Nuke virus, 25 XP. From Ellen M. at megamail.net to Detective Alex Murphy, DMPD. Home early? Alex, I know you love your job, but could you make a little sacrifice and not work late tonight? Jimmy is back from college, and it would be so nice to have a real family dinner, all three of us together. That is, if Officer Lewis doesn't grab you again for late night work. I love you, Ellen. Okay. Now let me check this event. 100 XP for getting into here. That puts me back out in the hallway. I'm sure the other one takes me into Detective Gum's office, but I need to hack that one open. Oh, maybe not. Nope, just puts me back out in the hallway right here. So, let's see, we've covered Wagner, we've covered Murphy. Let's go ahead and hack Detective Gum's door. Have to move quickly, thanks to the camera. Oh. Have to wait for the camera to start panning away. Now we have to move quickly. Fortunately, it's a simple grid.
Access granted.
Stop worm and 25 XP. 200 XP for exploring inside the office. That's handy. Alright, I've tapped two computers. This is the third. Let's go ahead and hack B Gum's computer. This is actually pretty straightforward, too. What? I did not want to use a stop worm. You piece of junk. Oh, well.
Access granted.
50 credits, 25 XP. We've seen all those emails already. So we got a shotgun, 155 credits, shotgun cartridges. And And looks like not too much else. So let's hit Detective McCann's office. He's snoozing. Get our stop worm back straight away. Pistol ammo in his desk. We have to wake him up, or else we won't be able to hack the computer. It'll be unlocked. So I've got two vents. I've hacked three computers, and I've hacked two doors. All right. Well, let's wake him up. That was easy. Take his pistol, reload my pistol, holster my pistol, lose the extra ammo, lose the vodka. I've got no reason to carry that around. Go ahead and make a concussion mine. Why not? Just to save some inventory space. Okay, yeah, we should be good. Now, let's hack his computer. That's four computers. Very good. This is the same as Chet's. It looks complicated, but it's actually extremely simple.
Access granted.
So, 25 XP for the hack. From Monique Rubens at yazura.det.usa to Detective Frank McCann, DMPD, regarding Robert. Hello, Mr. McCann. My sister told me that you stopped by our house last Thursday and wanted information about my husband, Robert. To answer your question, yes, Robert was augmented. He had an accident in the machine shop where he works about 2 years ago, and they had to replace his arm. Turns out he actually gained in productivity after that. You think this has something to do with what happened to him? I'm glad someone is finally working on this case. Thank you, Monique. And from Lieutenant Joan Ashbrook, DMPD, to Detective Frank McCann, DMPD, new assignment. Good morning, Detective McCann. I have to inform you that effective immediately, you have a new assignment. This is a top priority. That's why we've chosen you. You are, after all, one of the oldest investigators on the payroll, a veteran, and we need that experience on this case. We've had reports of multiple disappearances recently. Abductions, murders, not clear. The majority seem to be women, but in a few cases, augmented men have also been disappearing. People in the area are getting scared about this, and when people in Detroit get scared, you know something's fucked up. I'll have files delivered to you sometime today. Lieutenant Joan Ashbrook, DMPD. Okay. Let's check the office now. The rest of the desk, I don't see anything. I see nothing on the shelf. See nothing on the other shelves. So let's hit the vent. 100 XP for this vent. Awesome. Nothing over here. That's fine. That's fine. So we head over here. That takes us to Wagner's office, where we've already been. Over here. That's Jenny Alexander's office, but that's a door we haven't hacked yet, and I need to do it, so. Let's hack this last door. Hopefully, I'm out of sight of the camera for this one. Alright, this is pretty straightforward. Got a stop worm, and 25 XP for the hack. So let's head into Jenny's office. Another 200 XP, which is awesome. Alright, let's check things out. Credit chip next to the Lazarus radio. Playing the same broadcast as in the lobby, so we don't need to listen again. Alright, let's check the desk itself. Inside the drawers, we have machine pistol ammo, a pistol, and an automatic unlocking device. Awesome. Let's hack the computer. That's five computers, all three doors, all the exploration bonuses. So there are just two computers and an alarm panel left to hack after this.
There's more of this to come, followers, so stay.
This is very straightforward.
Access granted.
Got the nuke virus, 25 XP for the hack. From munchies at gaggle.det.usa to Detective Jenny Alexander, DMPD, the ballers. Sup, officer, I have some info you might want on your little DRB friends. I saw them stash some of the gats in a storage unit in the row. There's a top cat, DRB lieutenant, one bad motherfucker with a shotgun. He got the code to that storage on one of them pocket bitches. One other thing, if you guys plan to raid the crib, you should be careful in the maintenance corridor between D-Row and the spot near Chiron Building. They put some soldiers there. Now that's two tips. Two. So I want twice my usual CI rate. If you fuck me over on this, you can forget my help in the future. Munchies. From Hank the Tank at ScowlingMask.net to Detective Jenny Alexander, DMPD. You horrid now? Hey Jenny, I was walking around Grand River Road last Friday and I'm pretty sure I saw you on the corner there, dressed as a lady of the night. What's up with that? You dropped the badge? Hope you kept the cuffs though. Anyway, hit me back. We'll have lunch sometime. Hank. P.S. I assume you were working undercover. If not, please disregard the invitation. Alright. So, we've already checked out the roof access, so let's hack the alarm panel. Sitting here under the camera. Oh, so convenient. Alright. This is actually pretty straightforward. Let's just get the two data stores and then get the exit.
Access granted.
100 credits, nuke virus, 75 XP, disabled alarm. Done and done. Now, last thing is this holding room.
We're gonna stay here until I get some answers, kid. We're talking about some serious fucking crimes.
Crimes? What are you talking about, man? My brother's missing and you wanna charge him? Typical.
All right, let's try this again, from the top. When was the last time you saw Lucky, and who was he with?
I told you, it was like a week ago. We was hanging with some old friends.
Old friends, right. We know you both used to run with the Motor City Bangers. We know Jason is still in deep, and we know he's into something big.
Yo, you got all the answers. Why are you bothering me?
Okay, smart mouth. How does Og trafficking grab you, huh? Does that ring a bell? Maybe the DRBs are having a chat with your brother right now. What's the matter? Now you've got nothing to say? I've got all day, kid.
Okay, so there's some credit chips. We need to hack this one, and we need to pull this guy off so we can hack his computer, too. Now this is kind of the last little trouble spot. Let's try pulling him out. Too far away. Still too far away. No one cares.
Everyone down!
There we go. Alright, well let's try that again. Knowing I can just fire it in the room and remain undetected and still holster it makes things pretty easy. So let's crouch right here, pull the trigger, then holster
Everyone
it.
Everyone down!
Anyone there?
Okay. Both computers are locked. That's what you like to see.
Something's not right.
Try this.
I'm on.
Oh. Only got two of them. No dice. Okay. What I'd like to do is see if I can pull him out. With a little bit more. The odds of that aren't looking too good. We'll be done in the police station as soon as I manage to hack both of these computers, but as you can probably tell, that's not going to be that easy to accomplish. What the hell just happened to my frame rate? That was ridiculous. Alright, I'm having some kind of trouble here, folks. If you'll indulge me, I need to stop recording and figure out what the issue is. So, let me just pause it here. See if I can get Jensen to bring up his inventory. Yeah, this is bad. This is out of hand bad. Okay, I'm gonna pause here. Huh. I'm still having trouble. As soon as I turned off record, the FPS recovered fully, so it's something with my video software. It's not the game. So, what to do? I'll tell you one thing I know. I'd like to get all these guys.
What's that?
At least partially on alert.
Could have been the wind, I guess.
Well, that went okay, except for the damage I took. But I've been finding plenty. Well, hell, I have two hypostims. And there's a vodka over in the other room. Oh, I say we take that, just because I'm a little bit fed up with all this and I'm ready for it to be over. So let's search their bodies. Oops. That one's empty. This one's got 41 credits. That one's got 18 credits. That one's got some pistol ammo. Let's hack this one. Didn't really get more straightforward than this, just boom, 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 boom. Get the data store. Exit. 100 credits, 25 XP. And we've read all those emails already. Let's go over and get the last computer now. Frame rate issues again. What the hell is going on? I don't know, folks. I don't know. I managed to get off a quick save. And there, it spiked back up. Alright, let's hack this last computer. Mirror image. Same easy layout. Hundred XP in the data store, plus 25 XP for the hack. No new emails. And we are finished. So let's clear out of the police station now. Well, before we go, let's go drink that vodka. Just to get our health back to 100. I thought I left it somewhere in here. Guess not. Well, it doesn't matter. We'll find find a beer soon enough. In fact, I think I know where I left one. Oh, let's get out of here. Down to level 2, down to level 1, right out the front door where we came in.
Hello?
Nobody is the wiser.
No.
Which is good. It's what we want. One thing I did want to do, just, I don't think I looked at this. Return to Cassandra Reed. Looks like I found out everything I can about Megan's murder. Cassandra Reed is waiting for me in the lobby of my apartment complex. I should head to the Chiron building and speak with her. It's all very straightforward. I am just gonna head over to this street corner. Oh, there's the beer. Right where I thought it was. And just like that, we're back to 200 health. Alright, so right here, I'm gonna do a new quick save, a new permasave, with the police station completely clear, no reason to ever go back in, and we're gonna call that a video. Like I said, we're gonna call that a video. So, this has been Let's Play Deus Ex Human Revolution. Thanks for watching. Next time, we're back on the Detroit City streets. We're gonna tackle Adam's apartment and Derelict Row. So, I'll see you guys then. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.